Hi, my name is Michael Barry Judkins. I am the author of Interlude to Sentiment to Me, poetry collection under the AOS 21 Media House. I'm going to talk about the collection and the development of the Interlude to Sentiment to Me, the stage play Mercury Rising. When I was in the development stages of writing the collection, the Interlude to Sentiment to Me, which was funny because when I finished the first chapbook of poetry, the introduction, I immediately started writing the interlude, and this was in 2015, I would say the summer of 2015, and I had the theme, everything mapped out. I really wanted to get personal with this collection and this writing, and I wanted to write a full collection of poetry, and I wanted to take different aspects of what I learned in the craft of poetry along the way and what I want the reader to convey from getting this particular collection. So I kept it based on a lot of personal feelings and a lot of nature themes around this collection, the interlude. And I created this wonderful work of art, which I did it in two scenes, act one and act two. And I did 40 poem collection. And with the interlude, it was one of those particular projects where I allowed myself to dig deep. I allowed myself to be vulnerable and dig deep at the same time. So every poem in that collection, it went on a personal mission for me. So if I was talking about Twilight Moon, I remember when I wrote Twilight Moon, I sat outside where I live at in Allentown, and about 10 o'clock at night, and I sat outside on the grass in my apartment complex, and I just watched the moon. And I sat there for like about 3 hours to get the foundation of that piece. And I created Twilight Moon based off of that. And as far as when I wrote I Stand, one of my feature pieces, I took the strength of just me overcoming a lot of difficulties in my life and a lot of triumphs in my life and seeing how people around me was going through trials and tribulations of their own. And at the end of the day, we all stand as tall as the willow tree, slender, arched, and overbearing. And hence come for I Stand. So I just want to kind of give you a feel of what, or I should say how I created the collection, the interlude to Sentiment to Me. Now moving forward with that, during the development of the interlude to Sentiment to Me, it was published May 31st of 2016 under the AOS 21 Media House, and I've been promoting it through the year of 2016, which was amazing to me in itself, just having people read the collection, the response I got from the collection, and just being able to get my art out there any way that I can, and having people receive it and take from it. I even partnered up with several other organizations to help promote the product, to promote the book, just to kind of get a wider range of people that might be dealing with any type of issues as far as abuse, as far as depression. As a therapist, I know that's extremely important, so I wanted to make sure that people had resources to go to as well. And what I always do in my personal motto is the journey of life creates my art. And that's what I put into this particular collection. So after the publication of the book came out, when the book came out, I said the interlude needed more. And I said, I really wanted to kind of expand this collection and really make it more than what it is and make the reader understand where I was coming from with this collection and how personal this collection meant to me. So I partnered up with a playwright from California, Mona Rose, who's another poet. And we looked at the collection and I said, I want to make this into a stage play. So I picked 18 out of the 40 poems in this collection, and we started writing. And we developed the interlude to Sentiment to Me, Mercury Rising, the stage play. And the stage play is based on Mercury, I guess in a sense, is my alter ego, or that person, that other side of me, that is that person that's the dreamer, that knows that his art is what saved him, or I should say his art is his stability in a world where things are instable around him. And his art is one of the things that keep him grounded and keep him going. And I know that as a poet or as a writer in general, sometimes you need that motivation to keep you going. When there's times when you don't feel like writing, when it's time that where the world don't allow you to write, so to say, and then you just need to write, you need to get it out. And I always, when I say that, it always takes me back to the moment when I first took a pen to a paper and realized I had an act of writing was when I was in my high school global studies class, and my teacher, I finished the exam pretty early, and so I had about 10, 15 minutes left in the class, and she, you know, I was walking around the classroom, and I'm just sitting there, and I'm like, okay, what I'm gonna do, the bell's gonna ring, should I go to the bathroom and just hang out for 15 minutes, or I need to sit in the classroom? So I turned the exam over, and I just started doodling on a piece of paper, and I didn't know what I was writing. I was from the era of, you know, where hip hop was coming, so I knew a lot of music. You know, I have a very good music background, so I was just writing and just writing. And next thing I know, I submitted the exam, and the following week when I came back to the class, I got an A- on the exam, and I didn't study for it, so I was just like, oh wow, okay, what was this about? And she actually gave me extra points because she turned the paper around, I guess, in the grading, and she wrote on the top of the page, you need to pursue a career in writing. And I was flawed by that expression, because I still don't think I'm at that level of my writing to where, you know, I can consider myself the top or in that realm yet. But that inspiration kept me inspired to continue a writing career or to continue writing and developing a craft for poetic expression. And so my teacher, Anne, this goes out to you. Thank you for that. You know, you'll always be special to my heart to giving me that motivation to continue writing. So when just a little tidbit of, you know, what started me with writing. So talking about the play, the interlude of Sentiment to Me, Mercury Rising, so we started drafting out the script, and I just knew exactly what I wanted, you know, as far as the characters, as far as the theme, as far as having all the characters come from diverse backgrounds and having all the characters meet up in a centralized urban environment, and knowing that one thing that embodies them, one thing that they share in each walks of their own life is the expression of their art, and that there's all kinds of poetic stance around us. And that was the basis of creating this stage play based on the poems. And it's funny because I originally thought, like, should I do it like a one-man show? And I was like, you know what? I don't want to do it like that. I want to do it to where I can get people involved. And I want to do it in a sense to where it's not just focused on me, it's focused on creating a body of art and how we feel as creatives. Working together collaboratively and with people is sometimes the best experiences that you can have as a creative. And that's what this collection means to me. So when we was drafting the script for the stage play, that's what the focus was for me. That's where the focus had to stay for me, and I think we worked well together, and we drafted a really great script, 15 characters with the lead Mercury in it. And each of them have a different story, each of them have a different walk of life, but what bounds them is having that poetic expression to them. And I think that was the piece that made me smile every time I continuously read this script and make me smile and wanted to bring it to the world. And I said, one of the things I wanted to do is not just bring it to the world, but tell the world why I'm bringing it to the world. And again, I go back to my motto, the journey of life creates my art. And that transcends to everybody. The journey of your life creates your art. You know, there's art all around you, and you have to be able to see the art in you and around you to be able to create the art. And don't be shy to express the art. And one of the things that propelled me to take it to the next level, I should say, and make this play a reality, is to bring it to my reader that we all have a journey and we all can create the art through our walks of journey. So I believe that this stage play would be a family-friendly, poetic expression of the written word, and that everybody involved and everybody that would join and come see the stage play would take home something and feel like you as a person are creative in its own self. So thank you for taking the time out and just reviewing this video and sharing a couple of minutes with me while I give you my thoughts on the Interludes of Sentiments of Me, Mercury Rising. And I hope that you come out and see the play. Again, my name is Michael Barry Judkins. I'm a creative under the AOS 21 Media House. And I'll see you at the stage play.